வெல்கம் பேக் டு தி எம்ஆர் அகாடமி. இது மாணவர்களுக்கான தளம் மட்டுமல்லாமல் வேலை தேடுவதற்கான தளமாகவும் மாற்றமடைந்துள்ளது. உங்களுடன் நான் ஜி சக்திகுமார், எம்எஸ்சி பிஎட், கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ், பிஜி அசிஸ்டன்ட் என பிரைவேட் ஸ்கூல். அண்ட் இன் திஸ் வீடியோ 12th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் கம்ப்யூட்டர் அப்ளிகேஷன் சப்ஜெக்ட் சாப்டர் 7 அண்ட் த லெசன் டைட்டில் இஸ் லூப்பிங் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர். வி ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் லூப்பிங் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் அண்ட் லெட்ஸ் go inside the video. And now for computer application 12th standard subject, we are going to discuss about the chapter number 7, looping structure. Based upon the control structure, that means conditional control statements, conditional statements, we have a branching statement and looping statement. Two categories are there. I already clearly said you, control normally executed in this sequentially, line by line execution is done by the computer or interpreter. When the control structure is involved inside the program, we can change that executive order based upon your condition, based upon your requirement. Already we are discussed in last lesson conditional statements. If else, else if, switch. These are, we are already discussed, and these are the branching statement or conditional statements. Next one is looping. Here we need to understand the importance of looping structure and different types of looping structure. We know that in PHP, and to know the basic fundamental logic creation using looping structure, how to create in C inside the program, and what is, first of all, introduction looping structure. Iteration logics we are called here. Inside the conditional statement, that means if else, switch, these any kind of statements, the result will be single type, whether condition is true or false. Only single output, that means single block will be executed. That will be, that may be true or true block or false block. Any one of the block will be executed. Here also, one block will be executed when the condition is true, but till the condition is false, the block will be executed in repeatedly. When condition going to be false, on that time only the looping process will be stopped, that execution process will be stopped, otherwise continuously happened, right? In PHP also is there for loop, while loop, for each loop and do while loop. Except for each loop, other three loops are there in every programming language. But in PHP, the for each loop is special. An individual loop is used here for the purpose of dealing with the array. Specially dealing with array for this, to use this for each loop. First of all, we are going to discuss about the for loop. Anyway, any kind of the statement inside the program, we have a general structure, that means syntax. Based upon the syntax, we need to frame the statement inside the program, right? First of all, for keyword, it is mentioned this is the for loop, and inside the init counter, that means initialize the value. First of all, init counter means initialize the variable or value, right? And here test counter, that means condition check here, and then comes to the code to be executed, and then goes to the increment counter. So the process is, listen carefully, it's the first stage, it is the second stage. Inside the loop,
this is third stage and this is fourth stage, and comes after that the condition is the control is not comes here, only start with here second time, right? And then init counter, that means initialize the variable, is executed only once when the program is started or when the execution is start for the for loop. Other time of the same execution time will not work. Condition counter is working many number of times till the condition is false, right? And test initialize the condition is the first, initialize the variable is first one, test counter is second one, third one is block of statement inside the block, and fourth time is increment counter or decrement counter, and then again condition checking, right? So this is the sequence of for loop is executed, and the parameters, they are already I said init counter initialize the loop initial counter value, text counter evaluate the every iteration of the loop, every time we can check the condition true or false. True means loop is executed, and suppose false means comes out of the loop and will be not comes inside the block. Once you must remind condition, when the condition is true, the control will be comes inside the block of the statement. Suppose condition false in the first time also, the control will be skip total code inside the block, goes to the next statement of from the loop, right? And last one is increment counter, increase looping counter or decrease the looping counter, right? I already said the sequence of execution: initial, condition, statement, and then action after the iteration. It's a common looping, and after that goes here, and then condition true means comes here, and like this sequence. If the condition is false means directly comes out from the loop, and it's an example I less than or equal to 100, I equal to 0, that means 99 times this loop will be executed. That means welcome to Atlela, like this statement will be executed up to 99 times, right? Here they are giving an example for loop, starts with the PHP, and for initialize the I value equal to 0, they are putting dollar sign means a variable, and after that I less than or equal to 10, already 0 is initialized, and condition checking is there is less than or equal, condition true because of the I value is less than 10, then the number is I, that means the number is, this is the output, the number is I means 0 first time, after that goes to the increment, and I value is incremented by 1, and then 1 less than or equal to 10, condition true, again number is 1, and 0 to 10 the value is displayed 1 by 1, break means line break. So each and every one of the iteration and will be displayed in a separate line. And next one is for each loop. For each loop, already I said it is exclusively available in PHP only for the purpose of dealing with arrays, work only with arrays. Whenever dealing with array, we can use for each loop, otherwise we can't use this one, right? The loop iteration depends on each key value pair in the array, right? See the syntax. For each, it's a keyword, and array is the value, that means we can give some variable to the as a parameters. And here SEQ, that means sequence, is one of the array 18, 20, 32. For each X of sequence X, and X is the index value of, then array S means index value. That means 18 is position ID is 0. The position is 0. And 20 is 1. And 32 is 2. Like the sequence is, if we are adding some more values inside the array, means the values, subsequent values added. That means index value. And suppose we are putting 10 after 32 means, or 42 after the 32 means, the index value is 3. So each and every one in array, it will be mentioned with the index value or key value, right? The X is a key, SEQ is one of the array variable. So print, just print the each and every one of the value inside the array.
And here they are given an example: student name, array, Mahilan, Inian, Lani, Sivi, and Shini. And here, for each loop, student name has a value. So, value, student name has a value. These are the values. So, here, directly print the values. So, what will be the happen? Mahilan, Inian, Lani, sequentially, one by one, it will be printed, right? And when you write code, you want the same block of code to run over and over again in a row, instead of adding several almost equal code lines in a script. We can use loops to perform a task, like functions. If the function we are used, the function will be fulfill the specific task, completes the specific task. Like that, we can use this looping also. And here, the next one is while loop. While loop is normally used in every programming language. First of all, check the condition. Here the syntax of the program, syntax of the statement. Initialization is separate. In while loop is checking the condition. If the condition is checked, true means the inside the block of statement will be executed. Otherwise, goes out of the loop. If the condition true means, block of statement will be executed, again goes to the condition checking process, right? They are mentioning the sequential numbers, which statement, which order will be executed. 1, 2, and 3, here updation means other statements, and goes to here. And suppose condition false means, exit the loop, right? And see the example of this one. Student count 10, student number 1. And while student number less than or equal to student count, that means student count is 10, student number is 1. So less than or equal to, condition true because of 1 is lesser than the 10, then student number, this will be displayed. See carefully, the student number is, it will be displayed. And student number, that means it's a variable. What is the value of this variable? 1. So the 1 will be displayed here. Student number is 1, and break, student number is incremented. That means student number is 1 already. Now it will be 2. Again comes controls here. Condition is checking. 2 less than or equal to 10. Condition true. Again, next line, the student number is 2. And then up to 10, the same, student number is 1, student number is 2, student number 3. Like the statement is executed one by one and print. When the student number variable is going to 11, the condition is false because of 11 is not lesser than the 10, because of 11 is greater than the 10. So the condition is false. At the time, the control will be comes out from the loop.
And last looping value is do while loop. Do while loop is also like that looping, but start with do statement. Here, other looping statement, first of all check the condition, then allows the control to enter the loop, the body of the statement. But here, directly control will be sent to the block of statement. After that, the exit point only condition is checked. Then this statement, any one of the time, the condition, whether it is true or false, the statement will be executed at least one time. That's the point in the do while. Just see the program and student count, student number, same example. Do, it's a keyword. Directly control enters here, echo student number is, what is the number value? 1, that will be printed here and incremented. After that, the condition is checked. 1 less than or equal to, that is 2 less than or equal to 10. Condition true again comes here. Like other statement, only check the condition in initial stage. The condition is true means the control will be enters into the inside the block, otherwise goes out of the block. But do while statement directly enters inside the block. After the exit point, only have the condition checking portion. If the condition is true, then comes inside the loop. Otherwise, one time already executed, then directly goes out of the loop. And this is the end of this video and end of this lesson also. We will see the next lesson on the next video. Thank you.
And this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe the channel. And if you have any doubt, means comment from the comment line. And if you are searching the job, means please send me the resume. The email IDs have inside the description window. And thank you for watching this video. Nandri, Vanakkam.